Welcome to State of Tech. Let's take a look at how to use the fingerprint reader. So I'm going to swipe down on the screen and tap in my settings, and then come down to lock screen and security. Now we did a whole video on how to choose your screen lock type, but in this one what we're going to do is we're going to focus on the fingerprint reader itself. So down below you see there in the biometric section there's the fingerprint scanner, and if we tap on that we're going to be able to add in our fingerprint. Now this is going to prompt us to also choose a secure lock screen such as a PIN, pattern, or a password, and then we can add in at least one fingerprint. So tap continue. Here you'll want to choose either a pattern, PIN, or password. For this example, I'm just going to go with a pattern. I'm going to draw in my pattern and then continue and then confirm that pattern to add the screen lock type. Just now tap confirm, and then it's going to ask me to register in my fingerprint by swiping down. Now this is very different from previous iterations of this because you would have to tap and hold on the fingerprint scanner, but in this example we're taking our finger and we're just swiping down on the fingerprint scanner, kind of rolling our finger over it. And I would recommend doing this with both hands, so register your index fingers at least, and you can also register whatever other fingers you want to, but your more common ones are going to be the index fingers. So all I'm doing is taking my finger and swiping down over the fingerprint reader, and I didn't get it fully the first time, so I had to kind of do it twice. So just kind of play around with that and make sure you get it done. So that's my right index finger. Now what I can do is either tap done, and that's going to save just that one fingerprint, or I can tap add, and I'm actually going to hold the phone in my left hand and then swipe the fingerprint reader in the same way. So here I am adding in my left index finger, and I've got that done. I can choose to add in another one. You can have a total of 4 fingerprints added in here. So I'm gonna go ahead and just leave it with these two, tap done, and now I'm gonna go ahead and try it out. So all I have to do is tap my finger on the reader, and if it turns green, it's gonna tell me that my fingerprint is recognized, and now I can actually use it. So the next step is gonna be customizing our notifications on the lock screen. So I can choose to hide my content, I can choose to have the icons only, I can adjust the transparency, and I can even choose to turn this off if I want to, so I have no notifications on my lock screen. But this is part of the options with lock screen because the fingerprint reader is gonna be an added security of getting into our device. So now that I've done that, I can tap done, and now you can see both my fingerprints are here. I can choose my fingerprint verification for Samsung Pass and Samsung Pay, and I can even choose to unlock it with my device. Now what's also cool is we can tap edit to manage our fingerprints. So I have fingerprint 1 and fingerprint 2. I can choose both of them and just delete them, or I can choose one of my fingerprints and even rename it. What's nice is out here on the main screen, if I tap and hold on the fingerprint reader, this is my right index finger, and you can see fingerprint 1 is my right index. So now what I can do is tap edit, tap on fingerprint 1, and tap rename. I'm going to go and choose and rename this to right index. This is something that I just like to do myself. You don't really have to do it. You don't have to rename them at all. It's something that I do just so I know, and I can confirm that by tapping on the fingerprint reader. Now it's also nice as Samsung Pass, so here I can choose to verify and actually unlock Samsung Pass with my fingerprint reader. I'm going to need to confirm my password to get into my account, and then I can use my fingerprint reader to actually unlock my Samsung account. The same thing does go whenever we come back into the fingerprint portion for Samsung Pay, and then we can choose to unlock our phone with our fingerprint. What's also nice is that Android has an option that if any sort of application requires a password and they would like to integrate it with the fingerprint reader, you can actually have some apps unlock with the fingerprint reader. I know in my example here, if I come into my apps, 1Password is a perfect example of this. Once you've actually logged in with your 1Password account, you can choose to use the fingerprint reader or any of the other biometrics to actually unlock the application without having to enter in your master password. I know that even some banking apps use that as well, like Chase and Bank of America. They tend to use these fingerprint readers as well to get into their apps and log in. So that is how you use the fingerprint scanner on your Samsung Galaxy S9. If you found this video useful, be sure and give it a thumbs up. Subscribe to receive more videos like this, and we'll see you in the next one.